I am Meghna Goswami, lecturer of Manibabula Nursing College, Hukat Vasarya University. Today I am going to demonstrate procedure of NG tube insertion and feeding.
So, what is nasogastric tube? Nasogastric tube is a long, thin, flexible tube inserted through nose and down into the stomach or small intestine. A nasogastric tube or NG tube is a special tube that carries food and medicine to the stomach through the nose. It can be used for all feedings or for giving a person extra calories. The size and type of NG tube will depend on need of the patient, include lavage, aspiration, enteral therapy or stomach decompression. What is NG tube intubation? So, nasogastric intubation is a medical procedure involving the insertion of plastic tube through the nose, throat and down into the stomach. Orogastric intubation is a similar process involving the insertion of plastic tube through the mouth. Nasogastric tube come in various size, that may be 8 French, 10 French, 12 French, 14 French, 16 French and 18 French. Types of nasogastric tube. Two types, Levin tube and sump tube. Levin tube is a single lumen, holes near tips, and it is a most common type of nasogastric tube. It prevents accumulation of intestinal liquids and gas during and following surgery. Prevents nausea, vomiting and distension due to reduced peristaltic action. It has radiopaque line. It is used for the final placement of NG tube. Second, sump tube. It is also called as a Salem tube. It has double lumen and radiopaque line. First lumen used for the suction of gastric contain. Second lumen for the blue extension open to room air to maintain a continuous flow of atmospheric air into the stomach. Control the amount of suction pressure placed on stomach wall, prevents injury and ulcer. Selection of nasogastric tube. Select the feeding tubes based on the tube's composition, intended use, estimated length of time required, cost effectiveness and tube features. Soft, flexible, small diameter tube, that is 8 to 12 French, is recommended for nasogastric feeding. Use polyurethane or silicone tubes for anticipate long-term feeding. Polyvinyl chloride PVC tube should be used for a short period of time, usually for gastric drainage, decompression, lavage or diagnostic procedure. PVC feeding tubes have adequate efficiency and are most cost effective. Purpose of NG tube insertion. To feed fluid when oral intake is not possible. To dilute and remove consumed poison. To instill ice cold solution to control gastric bleeding. To prevent stress on operated site by decompressing. To relieve vomiting and distension, to collect gastric juice for diagnostic purposes, to administer medicine and feeds as part of management of an obstruction. Indication: gastric garage, clients who are unable to maintain adequate oral intake to meet metabolic demands, surgical cases, ventilated patients, neuromuscular impairment, intestinal obstruction, and gastric lavage. Contraindications: nasal fracture, face bone fracture, oral surgery, cancer of esophagus, larynx and pharynx, esophageal varices, base of skull fracture, recent esophageal or gastric surgery. Scientific principles. There are total 7 principles: principle of anatomy and physiology, microbiology, psychology, physics, chemistry, economy, and safety and security. principle of anatomy and physiology. So anatomy principle, that is the root of insertion of NG tube, that is from the anatomical structure from the nose to the stomach. So when we are inserting the tube, the root of the NG tube, that is it will be start from the nose, it go to pharynx, then esophagus and stomach. The physiology, so physiology, that is when we are inserting NG tube, patient having no taste and it not stimulate hunger, so sometimes indigestion will occur. So here when we are giving NG tube feeding to the patient, we have to explain the patient which type of food we are giving to the patient so it stimulate the hunger and the normal physiology of the GI system will be occur. Second principle, principle of microbiology. It is a clean procedure. All articles should be clean. Wear the clean gloves for the prevention of cross infection and less exposure to body fluids. NG tube is in sterile package, so during the time of insertion only package should be open, and after it immediately we have to insert NG tube for the prevention of infection and contamination. Third principle, principle of psychology. So we have to explain the procedure to the patient if patient is conscious, and if patient is unconscious, so we have to explain the procedure to the family members. So it help during the procedure for the cooperation from the patient as well as from the family member. So while again we have to explain, while we are inserting the tube, it will be lead discomfort, restlessness and breathing difficulty. So the patient should mentally ready and advise patient try to swallow for the easy insertion. Fourth principle, principle of physics. So the principle of physics, again it will be divided into the five subtopic, that is the first gravity. So when we are inserting the tube, we are giving the Fowler's position, semi-Fowler's position. Same way when we are giving the feeding, we are giving the semi-Fowler's, Fowler's position. So by giving this position, the gravity will be arise. So because of that easy insertion of the tube, and same the food will be go because of the gravity. Second, length of the tube. If the length of the tube is more, so gravity will be occur, and because of that, the fluid will be go easily. Third, size of the tube. So diameter of the tube, if it is more, so the fluid will go easily. Fourth one, viscosity of fluids. If the fluid consistency is thin, so the fluid will be go easily. And the last, that is the friction. So friction, that when we are inserting the NG tube, we are applying the lubricant jelly. So friction will be, because of the lubricant jelly, the less friction will be occur, and because of that NG tube insertion will be do easily. Fifth principle, that is principle of chemistry. So while we are inserting the NG tube, we are applying the lubricant jelly on the tip of the NG tube. So while we are lubricating, it will reduce the friction and it will be easy to introduce into the nasal cavity as well as into the pharynx and esophagus. And the second effect of the, that is the local anesthetic. So while we are using the jelly, because of the local anesthetic, the patient having reduced the pain and the discomfort. Sixth principle, that is the principle of economy. So economy in the term of less time and money. So first we have to give the proper position for the insertion. Second, we have to collect all the articles near, that is easy to access, and second, that is the available. Then perform procedure as quick as possible, so it reduce the time and it will save the money also if we will give the proper position and insertion at one time. Seventh principle, principle of safety and security. The safety and security in term of, first we have to checking the placement, NG tube in proper position or not. If it is in proper position, we have to fix the NG tube so it will not misplace and not coming out. Third one, for the prevention of injury, we have to railing up the patient bed for the prevention of injury as well as fall down. Then If we are giving the feeding through the NG tube, so for the feeding before and after, we have to give the Fowler's position for the prevention of aspiration. Then before the feeding, we have to see the fluid. That fluid should not be too cold and hot. If it is too cold, so it will create a spasm, and because of that, indigestion will be occur. And if it is too hot, so it's damaged the mucosa and it will lead to burn. Complication, aspiration and tissue trauma. Placement of tube can induce gagging or vomiting, patient discomfort, epistaxis, pulmonary complication, and esophageal perforation.
Articles for nasogastric tube insertion: a big tray containing Ryle's tube, it is also called as a nasogastric tube for the insertion and feeding purpose. A syringe, that for the aspiration and for the checking the placement of the Ryle's tube. Lubricant jelly for the lubricating the Ryle's tube tip for the easy insertion. Micropore for the fixation of the Ryle's tube. Stethoscope for the checking the placement of the Ryle's tube. One bowl with the gauze piece if any aspiration will be there, so for the cleaning purpose. One bowl with the water, that is for the checking of the placement of the Ryle's tube. Kidney tray for the collecting the wet material and the aspiration. Paper bag for the collection of the dry waste material. A Macintosh with the towel for the prevention of the wetting clothes of the patient. And tongue depressor if the patient is unconscious. So in that condition, to open the mouth to see the placement of the Ryle's tube, it is not in the mouth. Now we will see the parts of the Ryle's tube. So this is Ryle's tube. It is also called as a nasogastric tube. So this nasogastric tube will be available from 10 French to 20 French. And this is the 16 French Ryle's tube that it will be appears when we are opening. So if doctor will advise, so 16 numbers, so it is written here. This is the 16 French Ryle's tube. The length of the Ryle's tube, it is maybe that is 105 to 120 centimeter. Now the parts of the Ryle's tube. So the Ryle's tube, this is the tip of the Ryle's tube, this is the body of the Ryle's tube, and this is the base of the Ryle's tube. Now the tip of the Ryle's tube, it is made up of this radiopaque material, and that hold the body, that will be the radiopaque line will be there. So this radiopaque line will helpful to find out the placement of the Ryle's tube, it is in stomach or not, by the x-ray. Now this is the tip. The tip is blunt to avoid the injury during the insertion of the NG tube. Then this is the lateral eyes. These are the 4 to 5 lateral eyes are there. So this lateral eyes is helpful for the prevention of the complete blockage of the Ryle's tube. Then it will be help for the feeding as well as the aspiration from the stomach. And this is the radiopaque line that will be present in the Ryle's tube. Now this is the base of the Ryle's tube. So that this base of the Ryle's tube, it is a crock that will be open and the close of the Ryle's tube, and it will be open, and the nozzle of the syringe will be fit here for the feeding as well as the aspiration. And this is the made up of the plastic, that is the PVC, and while we are opening, that time it is in, the sterile packet will be there, and this is sterilized by the ETO, that is the ethylene trioxide. Now we are going to see the procedure of NG tube insertion. So first, that is the preparation of the patient. So preparation of the patient, if the patient is conscious, so we have to explain the procedure to the patient. If patient is unconscious, so we have to explain the procedure to the family member. After the procedure explanation, we have to see, already we have done the assessment and history collection. Again, we have to see the nasal septal deviation is there or not before insertion, and there is the issue of nose bleeding is present or not. Then we have to give the patient comfortable position. So here we will give the semi-Fowler's position to the patient before inserting the NG tube. So after comfortable position, we have to spread the Macintosh with the towel on the chest of the patient for the prevention of the wetting. Then we have to do the hand washing. I have done hand washing. Then it is a clean procedure, so I have wear the clean gloves, because there is a chances of when we are inserting, there is a chances of the fluid contamination. So the prevention of the crohn's infection, we have to wear the clean gloves. Now after the comfortable position, now we are going to do the NG tube insertion. So before the NG tube insertion, this is a package of NG tube insertion and it is sterile one. So while we are opening, we have to careful because it is a sterile and it will be go inside the body. So we have to open it carefully. Then we have to take the NG tube in the hand and in the rotating manner we have to hold in the hand. Before inserting the NG tube, we have to take the measurement of the how much NG tube we have to insert inside. So here in the NG tube, the body, the marking will be there. That is, it will be start from 50, 60 and 70. So this marking, it will be in some of the NG tube, the 40 centimeter will be also there. So this 40 centimeter from the tip, it will be indicate when we are inserting, it will be go to the cardiac sphincter. The 50 centimeter, it will be show that the this rise tube will into the stomach. The 60 centimeter, it will be show it will be in the pylorus part, and the 70 centimeter from the tip, it will be indicate that it will be go into the duodenum. Now normally the esophagus length, the anatomical structure, the 25 centimeter will be there. So here approximately when we are measuring for the adult, so it will be between the 50 to 60 centimeter. So how we have to measure? So from the tip of the nose to the earlobe, we have to keep like this way. We have to do the measurement. It will be not touched to the patient's body because it is the sterile one and it will be go inside. So there is a chances of infection. So we have to measure from the tip of the earlobe and from the earlobe to the xiphoid process. So here, so that is the approximately length. So it will be show after the 50 to 60. So that will be indicate this much we have to insert into the patient's nose. So after taking the measurement of the NG tube, before introducing the NG tube, first we have to lubricate the tip of the rhinoceros tube. So before introducing, first the lubricating jelly will be there. We can open it, and sometimes before the procedure also some contamination or the hard things will be there. So some of the portion we have to discard into the kidney tray. Then we have to keep on the our palm and we have to lubricate it. So now we have to lubricate the tip of the rat, that is 5 to 6 centimeter we have to lubricate. After lubricating, we have to insert on the patient's nose tree. So if the patient is conscious, we have tell the patient to, while introducing, there is some discomfort will be there, and before introducing, tell the patient to swallow for the easy insertion. So we have to lubricate, and slowly slowly, as quick as possible, we have to introduce, because the sometimes there is a chances of patients not feeling well during insertion. If patient having restlessness, breathing difficulty while we are inserting, so there is the chances of the placement is not in the stomach, maybe it will be into the respiratory system, and patient having more gag reflex and the restlessness with that, immediately we have to check the base of the tip. We have to take the bowel of with water, and the base of that tip we have to keep into the bowel, and if the continuous bubble will be there, so it showing that the this NG tube into the respiratory system. So immediately we have to remove, again we have to clean it, and then again we have to insert into the NG tube. Now when we are continuous and tell the patient swallow, 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 so it is easy to insert. We have measurement, so that is it is between 50 to 60 centimeters. So we have to introduce till that. Okay, so now it is already 50 centimeter, it is going up. So now that is the here the 60 centimeter will be there. So more than 50 we have inserted. So this is the insertion of the NG tube. So after the insertion, this is between to 50 to 60 centimeter we have measurement we have done, and according to that we have insert. So after the insertion, now we have to see the placement of the NG tube, that is in stomach or not. So after this insertion, first there are total three methods are there for the confirmation of the NG tube. First method, that is the X-ray method. So already we have seen the radiopaque line will be there. So after the insertion, the X-ray will be taken, and it will be the radiopaque line will be visible into the X-ray, and it will be show that is the placement in stomach or not. The second method, that is the auscultation method. So in the auscultation method, with the help of the stethoscope, we are administered the air. 10 cc administered the air into the NG tube, and we are keeping the stethoscope on the left side of the abdomen. So here from the xiphoid process, we can take 2 to 3 finger above left side into the hypochondriac region. We have to keep the stethoscope and we have to listen the sound. So that we are checking. So first we have to take the syringe, 10 cc air we have to take into the syringe, the tip of the syringe we have to keep into the base of the trials tube. So here we will fix it. So now we have to open it, take the stethoscope, and I already explained you that is the left side of the stomach, that from the xiphoid process, the two finger above here in the left contact region we have to keep the diaphragm, and now we have to introduce the air as quick as, and the whoosh sound will become. So when we are inserting air, so whoosh sound will become, so it will be indicate that the angiotube is inside the stomach. For third method of the angiotube in placement, that we have to aspirate the stomach contain or the gastric contain. So for that we have to first pinch the angiotube, and then the tip of the syringe we have to connect with on the base of the Ryle's tube. Then we have to connect, open the pinch and open the Ryle's tube. Then we have to withdraw the gastric contain, that we can consider as an aspiration. Slowly we have to withdraw. So if it will be in the stomach, the gastric contain will be come into the syringe tube, and sometimes we feel the negative pressure. How we can consider the negative pressure? So when we are withdrawing, the pressure will be there, so the plunger will be not coming out, it will be go inside, and we have to apply the opposite pressure. So after the confirmation of the placement of angiotube, now we have to fix the angiotube. So for the fixation we want the fixation tab and one scissor. So for the fixation we have to open the tab and we have to split into two for the easy fixation. So we have to put into the two, then we have to cut it and we have to fix. So this is like a butterfly shape. Now the base what we have remained, that we have to keep secure on the nose, we have to cover it. Then the two split, we have to open it and we have to cover it opposite direction. So here one on the another in the opposite direction we have to cover it and we have to fix it. So that is the fixation on the nose. Now sometimes it will be long, so again we have to cover it and we have to fix on the forehead. So again we have to cut the tap and we have to fix on the forehead. So we have to fix on the forehead, and if the part and it will be more, so we have to fold it and we have to keep on the patient's pocket. After the fixation, now we will do the recording and reporting of the procedure. So first we have to give the proper positioning, and we have to see the patient's comfort, as well as if the patient will be alone, we have to up the saddle for the prevention of the fall down. Now we will write into the nursing record. So in the nursing record, while we are writing the angiotube insertion, we have to mention the date, on which date we have done. So we can write the date, that is the today 19/6/2020, the time, that is the morning 9 a.m. In the nursing notes we have to write which number Ryle's tube we have used. So here I have used the 16 French, so that we have to mention in which nostril we have inserted. Then during insertion, if any complication or patient having breathing difficulty are present or not, that we have to mention. Then we have to write the during insertion if aspiration will be there. So color of the aspiration, how much amount of aspiration is there, that we have to record it and we have to mention, and we have to write the comfortable position, which position we have given. After the 10 minutes, again we have to record it and we have to observe the patient and ask the patient for any breathing difficulties present or not, that we have to see, and that also we have to mention. Well, after the completion of the procedure, we have to replace the article. So all the disposable material will be disposed according to our biomedical waste management. Then the stainless article we can wash under the running water. If any blood stain will be there, so we will wash and we will sterilize the material, and this towel we can send for the laundry and we will replace. After the procedure we have to record and report, and we have to see the position of the patient and we have to see the comfort of the patient. So I hope everyone understood about this angiotube insertion procedure. Thank you all and stay safe.